Peyton Manning. The Peyton Parade is on at the Mile High City. Here's Peyton throwing the ball at his first OTA workouts yesterday. Reportedly, he looked very good slinging it, too. This was Manning's first full workout in nearly 16 months. Said Champ Bailey, man, it feels good to know he's going to be on my side, because what I saw today, he's going to give us some good work, and we might not see a quarterback like that all year. Stephen A. Smith, respond.
Beautiful. Don't you love it? You know? Don't you love it? I mean, he's out there. He's dropped behind center. They said that his pass. Let me read. May I skip and Jay just read the lead article? It's on ESPN.com. It's the first line. And may I read it live to byline to Inglewood, Colorado? His passes were hitting receivers in stride. Excuse me. Don't interrupt. His passes were hitting receivers in stride and right between the numbers, not skipping off the ground or whizzing behind the heads like so many of Tim Tebow's. That's just a beautiful. I mean, I just want to give that writer a round of applause. Bravo. What a lead. What a lead. That's what I'm talking about, Skip. You know, you got Champ Bailey and others talking about the workout that they're going to have in practice every day. How, hey, this is the Peyton Manning of old. Watson drop behind center, the back injury, the spinal injury that messed with his throwing arm. All of that stuff is gone. No remnants of that whatsoever. They're just so excited. They're so happy to have a quarterback. The defense is actually getting worked out, Skip. That's what they're talking about here, you know, right? When they go to practice, we're talking about practice, Skip Bayless. They show up to practice, and what happens is when guys are actually running routes, you're not looking at cornerbacks taking plays off or whatever, wondering if they're at a bowling alley or a football practice. They don't have to worry about that anymore. They are definitely at a football practice because there's a real quarterback behind center calling plays, managing an offense, making accurate throws, which last time I checked, is the job of a quarterback. It's just beautiful. It's beautiful, Skip. It's beautiful. I see you going, but it's beautiful, Skip. It's just a beautiful thing.
Yeah. Are you finished?
And guess what? You don't get to talk about it tomorrow. You know I'm going to bring it up tomorrow, right? You know that, right?
I'm not. I don't think I get to talk about it today. I think we're almost already out of time for this segment since you rambled for so long.
I think so.
About how beautiful it was.
That's beautiful.
First of all,
beautiful.
The lead to the story was a cheap shot, out of bounds. Oh. The writer should be censured for that. And number two, I love
beautiful
Peyton
writing.
Manning. I have proclaimed him the greatest regular season quarterback ever. And I will give you this, Stephen A. Smith. It's a joke to even put Peyton Manning and Tim Tebow in the same sentence, because Tim doesn't belong in a sentence with Peyton, because very few quarterbacks do. However, to steal one of your transition phrases, I remind you that Peyton Manning was throwing yesterday against the Denver Broncos secondary that probably made him look a lot better than he even is at this stage of his redevelopment after surgery, because that secondary wasn't very good and got torched off in last year. It was that defense, 20th rank, Stephen A., and it gave up some big numbers, such as 5 first-half touchdown passes to Tom Brady in a playoff game. So all I know is they will certainly be better off throwing the football with Peyton Manning. But do you think Peyton will win 7 out of 8 games in one stretch? I don't know. Can he carry that defense? Can he pull off 6 fourth-quarter comebacks? Can he win a playoff game and go to a second one? I'm not sure about that, Stephen A. I'm rooting for him to make
You're
a great
so
comeback.
Disrespectful.
But I just don't
you make
know,
no
neither
sense.
Do
You're
you.
You're disgraceful. You're disgraceful. 4-time league MVP, Super Bowl champion, one of the greatest quarterbacks you acknowledge in NFL history. And here you are talking about you don't know if he's going to do what Tim Tebow did, as if Tim Tebow did everything by himself. He had the defense on suicide watch for most of the season.
No, he didn't.
Because he had him on the field entirely too much. This dude right here, I mean, you're unbelievable. It really is amazing some of the things that you would just ignore. LeBron James gets called out, but Tim Tebow, he's a godsend. He is the second. You just need to stop. You really do.
LeBron
you really
James,
do.
Wait, LeBron James is a 3-time MVP, And all Tim Tebow did last year was turn the Broncos into the number one rushing offense in pro football.
He lucked up for a few regular season games.
Off the field much of the time.
He lucked up for a few regular season games, lost his last three, went up against the Pittsburgh Steelers, and I don't know what on earth Tomlin and LeBeau were thinking. Okay, won that game, and then got beat down and ramrodded by the New England Patriots. Just stop. Stop it.
316 yards against the vaunted number one ranked
Pittsburgh
defense.
If he wasn't having a three and out
stop.
Every second, all right, Tom Brady wouldn't have been able to throw. He wouldn't have had the time to throw five touchdown passes.